Let's take a look at the dictionary definition of a variable. In computer programming, a variable, also called a scalar, is a storage address paired with an associated symbolic name which contains a known or unknown quantity of information, often referred to as a value. In layman's term, a variable is a container that contains a value. Now, how exactly do we go about creating a variable? Well, in GDScript, to write a variable, you type out the keyword var, spelled V-A-R, followed by a unique name. This is important because a variable cannot have a name that already exists in your script. Now, to write a variable, you simply write out the keyword var, spelled V-A-R, followed by your unique name, and everything in yellow is mandatory. However, everything in the parentheses is completely optional. This means you can create a variable that is empty, or you can assign your variable a literal value or data object using the assignment operator, which is represented by the equal sign symbol. Now, let's go ahead and take a look at two examples. In the first example, you can see here we've created a variable called player health, and we've assigned it with the assignment operator, the literal value, in this case, the literal integer value of 100. You can also create the same variable without assigning a value. In this case, we've created a variable called player health, and we have not assigned it any value. As a matter of fact, if we do not assign a value to our variables, they will contain the data type null by default. And again, variables must have unique names or an error is thrown. In GDScript, you can also use something called typed variables. A type variable is just a data type that is explicitly declared on your variable by adding the colon symbol followed by the data type in which you wish to limit your variable. In this case, the first example is a variable called life points, and using the colon sign symbol followed by the int keyword, what we're saying is that our variable called life points can only have integer values assigned to it. Declaring data types on variables is usually considered good practice, as it leaves less room for confusion on the purpose of the specific variable. Assigning a value that is not the declared type will throw an error. Let's go ahead and take a quick look. In this case, we have a variable called text, and we've explicitly assigned it the data type of string, and we are trying to assign it a literal integer value of 10. This line of code will not work because it will in fact throw an error because GDScript is expecting a string data type to be assigned to our variable called text. In GDScript, values assigned to a type variable must have a compatible type. If you need to coerce a value to be a certain type, use the casting operator as. In the first example, you can see we have a variable called text with a declared data type of string, and we are assigning it the value 10 as a string. What this will do is convert the integer value 10 into a string value 10. The second example, we have a variable called a num, and we assign it the string value 10 as an integer. What this does is it converts our string value of 10 into an integer value of 10. Lastly, we have a variable called numFloat with the declared data type of float, and we assign it the value of the integer value 10 as a float. And again, this will convert our integer value of 10 into a float, which will then be assigned to our variable called numFloat. Common data types you may find yourself using with your typed variables include integers, booleans, strings, and floats. Instead of typing them out, you can also infer the data type onto your variable by the value or literal value you are assigning into that variable. For example, we have a variable called a number, and we are assigning and inferring both the integer value and the integer data type onto the variable called a number. The same thing is true for the variable called a boolean. We are inferring and assigning the boolean value true and the data type of boolean onto our variable called a boolean. And the same thing is true for our variable a string, which is being inferred and assigned the string data type and value hi friend. And lastly, our variable a float is being inferred and assigned the negative float value of 12.0. In GDScript, you may also assign an object that is the subtype of the cast type. Now, this is an advanced topic as we have not, nor will we be going over Godot-specific classes. If you want to learn Godot-specific classes, please feel free to view my Godot Basics tutorial series. Regardless, just for your information, GDScript does have the ability of casting classes. So in this case, you can see here, we have a variable called my_node2d with the data type of node2d, which is a Godot-specific class, and we are assigning it some type of sprite class value, and we are casting it as a node2d. Just so you know, the sprite class is a subclass of the node2d class. And again, a more advanced topic. However, we will be going over classes in a later episode. Now that we have gone over different ways of declaring our variables, I have laid out the actual format for declaring variables in GDScript. Again, the mandatory pieces of a variable is the keyword var, followed by your unique name. You can choose to opt it as a typed variable using the colon symbol, followed by your data type, and you also have the option of assigning it a value. However, if you choose to assign it a value, you must use the assignment operator, which is the equal sign symbol, followed by your literal or data object. And of course, you can combine these two by using the semicolon, followed by the assignment operator, followed by your literal value, assigning both the value and its data type to your variable, or in this case, your type variable. Let's quickly go over when you need to use variables. You should use variables when you have data that needs to change over the lifetime of the game or program. In this example, we have a variable called player health with an assigned literal integer value of 100, and the value of the player's health may in fact change over time. As you notice, the player health's value is not a constant. That's all I have for you in this episode. Thank you so much for joining me, and I look forward to seeing you in the next episode. Have an amazing day.